I was born in 1995. This makes me 29 years old as of the making of this video. Now, considering I'm currently far too busy making science videos on YouTube, I don't plan on having children anytime soon. Now that said, I've decided I'll be freezing my sperm, and in this video I'll explain the science behind why I've come to that decision, and why I believe more men should follow the example of women freezing their eggs, and freeze their sperm too. My name is Hesham, and I'm a medical doctor. This is Neuro Everything. So we'll talk about human studies in a bit, but I want to start off with an animal study. So let's start by looking at mice. In a landmark 2018 study, a team of scientists in Germany bred two sets of mice together. In the first set, a 4-month-old female mouse mated with a 4-month-old male mouse. In the second set, a similar 4-month-old female mouse was bred with a 21-month-old male mouse. And the scientists then compared the baby mice that were produced from the two sets. They very quickly realized that the mice that were fathered by the older male mouse died earlier, enjoying lives that were 6.6% shorter on average. I wish I could say that advanced paternal age only affects mice, but it doesn't, because it affects us as well. A study of nearly 31,000 patients at an outpatient clinic in Spain revealed that fathers aged 40 to 45 years old were 1.92 times more likely to have an intellectually disabled child than children born to fathers who were up to 30 years of age. And another 2017 study published in Nature comparing the intelligence of siblings showed that older siblings were on average more intelligent than their younger siblings.
Firstborn children do you have in here? Anybody firstborn, the oldest in the family? Look at him. 1, 2. Look at, you're so smart.
As older siblings tend to be born when their parents are younger, this creates a negative association between intelligence and a parent's age. But not just any parent. This effect was only associated with advancing paternal age, not with advancing maternal age, as you can see from the two graphs over here. According to this study, a child's intelligence is unaffected if they're born to an older mother, but it is if they're born to an older father. And this decline in intelligence, well, it starts pretty early on, beginning before a father turns 30 and continuing with age, which probably means that yes, I might actually already be too late with my sperm freezing plans, so fuck that. It can't possibly get any worse than this, or can it?
Fuck yeah! Yeah, 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 yeah.
It almost certainly can. Advanced paternal age doesn't just affect offspring intelligence. A different study was able to show that older fathers were much more likely to father children who had autism, ADHD, psychosis, substance misuse problems, and bipolar disorder. In fact, in the case of bipolar disorder, fathers aged over 45 were 24 times more likely to have a child who would later on in life be diagnosed with bipolar disorder than fathers aged 20 to 24. Now, misogynists on Elon Musk's hate speech platform absolutely love to fixate on women and their age, and what that age means for their ability to bear healthy children. That's probably because scientists studying reproductive medicine have, for the longest time, been obsessed with advancing maternal age, completely ignoring the impact of advancing paternal age on offspring health. It's unfortunate because, well, this obsession has produced some great research, by ignoring the impact of advanced paternal age, it has needlessly provided an insane amount of ammunition to the misogynistic assholes out there. But the most recent research is abundantly clear. Advanced paternal age could very well be worse than advanced maternal age. And it's because sperm, well, sperm are kind of special. Sperm cells are the smallest cells in the human body. They're absolutely tiny. The head of a sperm cell is around 5 micrometers long, 6 times smaller than the size of a white blood cell. Egg cells, on the other hand, are the largest cells in the body. In fact, they're so large that an egg cell is around 20 times larger than a sperm cell. The reason all of this matters is because of the enormous challenges it introduces on sperm cells. Because they're so tiny, sperm cells need to put serious effort into compacting their DNA, the DNA that would go on to contribute half of their offspring's genetic material. The DNA in nearly all of our cells has some degree of compaction. This compaction is achieved by proteins called histones, which go on to attach to our DNA and compress it. However, the DNA compaction in sperm cells is so extreme that sperm DNA ends up 10 to 20 times more tightly compressed than the DNA found in egg cells.
Tight. It is tight.
It's basically a real estate issue if you think about it. Achieving this high level of compaction requires the sperm to use specialized proteins known as protamines, as histones cannot achieve this intense level of compaction. And as far as we know, sperm cells are the only cells in our entire body that make use of protamines. No other cell in the body makes use of them. It could very well be that protamines evolved specifically to achieve the high degree of compaction needed in the sperm cells that we find in mammals today. This means that protamines are a much more recent innovation than histones, which can leave them much more vulnerable to failing, and God, do they fucking fail. Research suggests that protamine levels decrease dramatically in older men, and that this decrease is frequently associated with infertility, as well as DNA damage. In short, with less protamine available, the sperm DNA begins to fragment. It breaks apart, it becomes more methylated, which changes the expression patterns of many genes, leading to adverse health outcomes for the children born to older fathers. This is important because if you jog your memories back to the start of this video, you'll remember how I told you that mice born to older fathers had shorter lives on average. Well, the scientists who had these experiments done, they didn't just stop there. They also sequenced the DNA of the mice that were born to old fathers and compared this DNA sequence to the mice that were born to young fathers. They identified 484 genes that were improperly methylated and therefore likely to be misexpressed in the mice with older fathers. These genes played important roles in cellular metabolism, in regulating the immune response, in DNA repair, in brain size, and in neurogenesis, which can explain the difference in intelligence between siblings that I described earlier. Perhaps even more alarmingly is that these differences appear to persist generationally. Here's a small segment of the mouse sperm DNA. It compares the sperm DNA of the mice born to young fathers with those that were born to old fathers. It appears that older fathers don't just affect their own children, but also their grandchildren. In one study, in humans, older fathers were found to be 1.5 times more likely to have a grandchild with autism than younger fathers. And on that note, you should find a link to all my citations in the description below. In the description, you should also find a link to a Substack blog that I wrote about how exercise can actually improve the quality of both egg and sperm DNA, leading to better health outcomes for your children if you plan to have them. If you don't, that's okay too. If you'd like to give that a read, check it out. Thanks for sticking around to the very end. I appreciate you giving me some of your valuable time. My name is Hashem, and this is my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all next time.